Well, 8 years ago, it was definitely a homebrew operation. Why don't we take a trip through the time tunnel and see what's evolved in the Apple II line in the last 8 years? Right over here, we've got the very first computer we ever built, long before we even started a company. And back in those days, you had to scrounge all the components you could for as free or as cheap as you could, and there's probably under $200 total that ever went into buying a few parts at the local electronics store. I hand-wired the entire bottom, soldered it all together personally, because there was no way to afford a technician, and that was an Apple I, the first Apple I computer ever. The case, we didn't deliver them in a case. It was sort of like everyone you had to customize yourself, so a friend's father built the case. Over here, as we work our way through the time tunnel, exhibits on the software which we had to write ourselves. Couldn't afford tools like assemblers, so we had to learn how to assemble it ourselves on, by hand on paper. And it was a very unusual experience for such a successful product. Got examples of the interface boards that we had to design to plug accessories into the first Apple II computers. Here's an Apple I PC board. The keyboards over time evolved. The first keyboard I bought from Datanetics because I saw an electronics magazine advertising it for $60, and that was cheap in those days. And we evolved it over the years and added features and keys. The cassette tapes were how we stored our software in the original days because we didn't have a floppy disk until about a year after we introduced the Apple II computer. And way in the corner is an example of how you had to customize every individual Apple I because we did not supply a case with the computer. And that would be the first, we originally conceived of these as the Apple I and the Apple II as the first portable computers of all time. And of course, that the word has changed over time. Here we got some examples of different color plastic cases we played around with, and I think we chose the right one. And up on the wall are a couple schematics of the Apple II computer, which are kind of interesting because the first schematics were all on dozens of sheets of paper, and you'd save a chip, so you'd throw it out and redraw it. But eventually, you have to draw it kind of nicely on a lab bench, and. So I hand drew these. You had to draw your own. We couldn't afford technicians or draftsmen. And then you just shade out the lines. Every time you connect a wire on the board, you draw it out so you'll get everything cooked up right. And this was the first Apple II schematic. It's on Hewlett-Packard paper because in those days you had to borrow what you could get. This is our new Apple IIc computer, and it's sort of a culmination of a lot of thinking, particularly that Steve Jobs had in the early days. We would argue, I said the Apple II should have 8 slots, and he said it should only have a couple, and that was about the only argument we ever had. After all these years, we can finally define what almost everyone wants in a computer, and by building it in, it's cheaper. So the Apple IIc doesn't have slots. It has built-in slots, and you just plug your monitors and your printers and your modems and everything in the back of it. So it's we finally came through on that, and it's a great cost-performance advantage to the purchaser. This is just one step. We've now got a finer package on the Apple II computer, but it's obvious that there are a great deal of enhancements that can go on beyond here. We've built a mouse into the Apple IIc because we believe this is the year of the mouse. A lot of the software products that are being offered out here today introduce new software for this product showing where the line is going. You can even buy hard disks that plug into the Apple IIc now. So in future years, you can expect quite a bit of expandability. This is our millionth Apple II computer, and that's why it's gold. And a million sounds like a large number, but you remember number one, you remember number 100. The one I remember most closely of all was number 10,000. After a couple of years, we had really made it big, and they gave me number 10,000 as sort of a tribute. This is number a million of the Apple IIs, and that'll probably seem small in a couple of years.
And the last segment of my video blog, I come to pick up a bouquet. But check out this bouquet. This bouquet is made out of candy. And what makes this bouquet so very damn freaking cool is that you can eat it. I clean up good, right? And from all my geek friends, here's this 22-year-old Lisa computer. And God knows, what is this, like 15? Next Cube, right? There it is. I do have these two pieces of fine equipment. I will be booting them on film. You will see these things working, maybe. Maybe not. They might blow up. Cool.